Welcome back to the channel. So this is Stitched Up Weekly, but it's slightly different because it's the weekend and I've wanted to vlog for a couple of weeks. I know I've been a little bit absent. As you know, I started a new job recently and this week was the launch and we've been gearing up for that and it was just so busy. The last couple of weeks, even though I've been working from home, I was incredibly busy. And yeah, this week we've launched the service and it's been very difficult, shall we say. And each week, the last couple of weeks, I have started vlogging and then it's just not happened. So I'm really sorry that I've been missing in action, so to speak, but I am back now. Yeah, I've wanted to vlog all week, but I've been so busy at work that it just didn't happen. So I'm here now. It's Saturday. I will sort of fill you in a little bit on what's been going on. The kitchen and the floor is done and I'll show you that in a minute because it looks amazing. I'm so happy with it. The floor that was supposed to only take 3 to 4 days actually took 6 days to fully fit, but it's beautiful. It's really beautiful and yeah, I'm really pleased with it. It really transforms the downstairs of the house, which is amazing. It was my birthday on Monday, so I turned 48 on Monday, which is scary that I'm only a couple of years off that next decade. It was I can't say I had a happy birthday. I mean, I did, because I had loads of lovely well wishes from people and some lovely presents and cards, and you know, but where it's difficult because I was at work. It was the first day of our new service and there was only me because other people are either self-isolating or backed out at the last minute, so it left me covering the whole service. So it was a long day, very difficult day, and at the end of the day I got a flat tire before I could come home as well, so yeah, it was a write-off. However, when I did get home I had a massive surprise, which I had no idea about, and well, Martin and Isaac gave me their cards and presents and then they said, we've got another surprise for you, close your eyes. And when I opened my eyes, Bronte was there, which was amazing. I've not seen her obviously since we were on holiday in Cornwall and I had no idea that she was coming up, so it was just a wonderful. Martin actually filmed it, so I will insert a little clip to show you my reaction when I saw her, because it was so much needed after the end of a really long, tiring, exhausting day.
Right, you can open them now.
Happy birthday!
So she stayed with us for 3 days. She went back on Thursday and I was at work for most of it, but it was just lovely having her home. So that really turned my birthday around. It was just so nice to see her. So yeah, so house is back to normal now. I spent the entire weekend last weekend cleaning up and getting things straightened around. So it finally feels, after months of flood damage and yeah, just being totally upside down, that we've finally got there just in time for Christmas, which is lovely. We've gone back into lockdown in the UK, although it doesn't feel like a lockdown, shall I say. I've been at work obviously, and I was at work yesterday and the roads are no quieter than they have been, even though people are supposed to be working from home if they can. So I don't know really, it's a bit strange, but most of the shops are shut apart from essential shops. So we're back in that cycle again, I think, but I'm not letting it get me down. I haven't had any opportunity to do any sewing for about 3 weeks now. I did do a little bit last weekend. Remember the ultimate trousers that I made? In fact, you probably haven't seen them, but I think I'm gonna try and film my September and October makes vlog this weekend, because I'm gonna redo it because I think I had a bit of a disaster with the trousers or something. So I'm gonna redo that. The zip broke in the ultimate trousers on the second wear, so I needed to replace that. So I did get that done last weekend, but apart from that, I've done no sewing at all. However, now I have 3 days off. It's Saturday. I'm off today, tomorrow and Monday, because we were supposed to be going to the Lake District for a long weekend. And obviously with us going into lockdown on Thursday, that's now been cancelled. So I've still got the time off work and Martin has as well. He's just gone to do the food shop and I am going to have a bit of a sewcation. So I will show you what I'm planning to sew. I've picked out 3 or 4 different fabrics and patterns from my stash, which I'm probably not going to get all those done this weekend because we are going to do some other things apart from sewing. But I'm really itching to get sewing again because I have lost a considerable amount of weight in the last few weeks. Yeah, I'm really feeling it now. And a lot of my clothes are that I made sort of last year and earlier this year don't fit me now. Well, I'm not quite at the point where the clothes that I made a few years ago when I was at my smallest, they still don't fit me, but so I'm in that in-between stage at the minute, so I need to make myself some black trousers. So I know that's boring, but you know, they're a staple, aren't they, that we all need. So I'm planning to do those this weekend. That's going to be my first project, I think, but I will show you the other bits and pieces that I'm looking at as well, and we'll see how we get on. So I thought that you would like to come along with me and spend the weekend with me and see what we get up to, and so we'll see how we get on. But let me show you the floor, because I'm sure you're dying to see it. Well, I hope you're dying to see it, because I've been going on about it for so long, haven't I? So okay, so this is the conservatory back to normal, and this is my parquet floor. I've now put the unit that was over by the window, the sort of bookcase, there. I've got my chair back and my plants as well. My friend Jane is back in the house now, so her dining table and chairs have gone. My gorgeous vintage Singer sewing machine is just over there as well, and this is the floor, so I'm absolutely delighted with it. It's beautiful. I'll just walk you through into the kitchen. It's just gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. So yeah, the floor goes all the way up to the dining room. It's all edged as well. I don't know if you can just see that there. And kitchen is now complete. So it's been a long job. I know it's been a long job, but it's been an unprecedented year, hasn't it? So I still need to get some lovely pots for my two plants. I've not managed to find any that I like yet, so I'm sure that'll happen at some point. But yeah, I'm delighted with the floor. It just looks beautiful. So so that's the floor. And living room, I will show you that, even though it's not finished yet. So what we have done is we have redecorated, and I've got that amazing wallpaper up. Now, I think I mentioned previously that I wasn't sure about it, but actually I think it looks okay. So that's on the now feature wall behind the TV. The floor has been restained darker, so now it's walnut. This colour that I've got on the walls is a Farrow and Ball paint called Peignoir, and I've got a new picture which I absolutely adore. I got this from the range, it wasn't expensive, and we've still got the same lamps, but I got different shades for the lamps again. They were from the range. And then the main chimney breast wall is in Shira Blue, again by Farrow and Ball. We've stained the beam across the top and painted at the back of the fire as well. And new curtains. I haven't made the curtains, I'm afraid. Yeah, you can't see them very well, but these are just some curtains that I got from Next. Hopefully you can see that. They are sort of a silvery grey, but the light is affecting how they look, but they're just plain and they're heavyweight and they are lovely. Obviously not got the new sofas yet. I have got another set of these curtains, but just in the smallest size, because I am planning to recover my foot stool once we get the new sofas. Still need a new rug. The rug that I've seen that I want is in IKEA, but I haven't had the opportunity to go to IKEA to get it, and it's shut now because of the lockdown. We've had confirmation as well that the sofas that should have been here a couple of weeks ago have been delayed, and they're going to be delayed even longer because of lockdown now. This gorgeous little lantern I bought from the range as well. It's actually a hurricane lamp, so there is a candle in there. And I've also got this little tea light. I'll just move one of my birthday cards. This gorgeous tea light holder, again from the range. And this gorgeous vase my daughter bought me for my birthday from Next,
And I've also got that little silvery bowl as well. So all in all, it's more or less done in here, to be honest. As I say, we just need those gorgeous pink sofas, which I'm really hoping the pink birds and flowers will pick up the pink theme, if that makes sense. The colour of the wall, as you can see, it's like pinky grey. These colours are designed to work together. We've got a massive mirror to go up there as well, which I will just take you through into the dining room and show you that. That is here, which is just beautiful. Yeah, it's got this gorgeous sort of filigree in a pewter colour frame. So that's going to go up above the fireplace. I think Martin is going to do that today. So yeah, so I'm really pleased with how everything's looking. It's nice to get everything tidy and clean and straightened around again downstairs. So I'm going to show you what I am planning to sew today. So let me put you down and I will pick up all the patterns and fabrics, and then I'll chat you through my plans over the next couple of days. So I mentioned about trousers. I need some work trousers because the black trousers that I made last year, I think it was, are just too big now. And I did try putting them on yesterday for work and they were just falling off me and they just look ridiculous. So I do need to make some new trousers. So I've decided on the carry trousers by Sew Over It. Now I know these are quite casual, but I think in a plain black they will work really well because I can smarten them up with you know, a nice top or whatever. So I've got this fabric in my stash. Now I think this, I mean obviously it's just plain black, but I think it's a tencel. It's a tencel twill, and yeah, I've got loads of this, and I think it's got the right drape because the carry trousers do say they need a drapey woven fabric. So I think these will work. And I've made these once before. I made them for actually when we went to Canada a couple of years ago. Gosh, well, no, it's 18 months ago now. Yeah, and they were great. So I'm going to make another pair of those. And then the next pattern that I've chosen is the Day Dress by the Avid Seamstress, which is this one here. Now, I know it looks very, very basic, and it probably is quite basic, but I think for this time of year with a, you know, pair of tights and boots, it will look quite nice. Now the fabric that I've chosen to make that out of is I don't know if it's an art gallery or an Atelier Brunette. I think it's an Atelier Brunette, but it's this beautiful embroidered double gauze in a gorgeous sort of forest green colour with these beautiful gold embroidered dots on, and I really love it. It's beautiful. Now this pattern I think takes 1.5 meters. 1.65 meters it says, so I probably will have to shorten it because I don't know if I've got enough fabric. I think I've got 1.5 meters, so I'm gonna have a play with it anyway and see how I get on. But yeah, this is gonna be the Day Dress, and again that should be a fairly quick make. Even though I've not made that before, I don't think it's going to be difficult to trace that out and get it made up. Just keeping to the Sew Over It theme, I want to make another heather dress. Now, I've only made this once before, and it was when I was at my slimmest. So I've already got the pattern cut out, and I'm hoping I can still get away with it. I think because this is obviously meant for sort of a medium to heavyweight jersey, I think it will work okay. Because there'll be a bit of stretch in it. But the fabric I have chosen is this, which is this beautiful flocked jersey fabric. I got this from Colville Fabrics, I think last year or maybe the year before. And it's, you know, it's like a sort of midnight blue with a navy sort of flocked velvet animal print on it, I guess. It's really lovely. But I think that will make a lovely heather dress. So I'm going to have a go at that one as well. Again, that should be a fairly quick make because it is already traced and cut out for me. So I'm going to make the 3/4 length sleeves for that one as well, I think. And the last pattern that I've chosen is another dress pattern. And I wanted to have a look through my new look patterns because I've not made a new look pattern for a long time. So I picked out this one, which is N6594. It's this gorgeous dress here. So
I haven't made this one before, so I think this one is going to be the most in-depth make for me out of the patterns that I've chosen, mainly because there are a few pieces to it. Looking at it, the skirt is obviously panelled, and so is the top. You've got obviously a yoke and gathering as well, so I think there's going to be a few pattern pieces to this. I'm planning to make version C, which is that one there, so I think that is the sort of just below the knee length, which I think will be quite nice, but we'll see how we get on. I'm hoping I've got enough fabric for this, because version C takes 2 5/8 of a meter. But the fabric that I've chosen for this is this beautiful viscose, which I got from Material Girl Laura a couple of years ago, and I love this, it's so beautiful. But I think with, you know, I think the colours are right for this time of year, and it will look lovely with tights and boots. So hopefully I can get that done as well. So that's the plan for my sewcation this weekend, and yeah, we'll see how we get on. So right, first things first, it's going to be the carry trousers. So I'm going to try and move that mirror off the dining room table and get my cutting mats out and get these cut out, and then we'll see how we get on. One other thing I wanted to quickly just mention as well is the lovely Judy came over last night and we went for a run. Now, part of our new lockdown rules is that we can't have anybody else in our houses at all unless we've formed a bubble with somebody who lives alone. But you know, we can't meet up in gardens either, but we can actually meet up with one other person outside. So Judy and I generally, as you probably know, we do like to run together on a Friday evening, and we take it in turns. One Friday I'll go to her house, we'll go for a run, and then we'll have tea together, and then the following Friday she'll come to me. But obviously with the lockdown, we thought we'd have to stop that. So what we actually did was we decided that we would still go to each other's houses to go for a run, but we wouldn't come in the house and we wouldn't have tea together. So that's what we did last night. So Judy came over and we went for a run, and she bought me a lovely birthday present, which was so kind of her. So I'll show you what she got me. So this was the lovely gift that Judy bought me. She's bought me this really lovely sewing journal. I've never used a sewing journal before, but this is lovely. So yeah, it's you know, it's got loads of pages so that you can write down, you know, what you're making, and measurements and any fitting notes, etc. So yeah, I'm looking forward to using that. So that was really, really cool. It's actually the only sewing related birthday present that I got this year. So right, I'm gonna make myself a drink, and then I am gonna get the dining room table cleared so that I can get that fabric cut out.
This weight on my shoulders slowing me down. I don't know how it came about. And while the world is spinning faster every night, I feel I'm stuck in reverse somehow.
I feel the pressure on me, how it's itching under my own.
Right, so carry trousers are cut out. I'm up in my sewing room. And yeah, it's nice to be here again. Poor Bronte, when she was here, actually slept on the sofa because I haven't had a chance to sort my room out. And she couldn't be bothered to do it, basically. So she slept on my sofa. But one other thing I haven't mentioned is that we are without heating at the minute. Our boiler is about 5 years old now, I think. And the guy who installed it doesn't do boiler installations and servicing anymore. I don't know if I've mentioned before that where we live is very rural, so we don't have access to gas. So our boiler is an oil fired boiler, and they are very, very expensive, both to buy and install and also to run. I know this is really boring, but I just bear with me. We've noticed we've not been able to sort of have baths the last few months because the boiler keeps losing pressure, and every time you fill the bath it loses pressure and then the water runs cold. So anyway, that came to a bit of a head just over a week ago when we got up one morning, the heating didn't come on, we had no hot water, and there's another issue with it. Now, those of you that watched Vlogmas last year will remember that we had a big leak from the boiler last year because there was a mouse that had eaten through one of the pipes, which was just ridiculous. But anyway, we got that fixed, and then here we are less than a year later and we've got another problem, and it appears there is a leak with it, although the water's not leaking out this time. But anyway, to cut long story short, we have no hot water or heating at the minute apart from our stove, which is fine because that's keeping the house, you know, generally warm, but the hot water is a real issue. So we managed to get hold of somebody that was supposed to come out today to fix it. Again, it's going to be really expensive to fix, which is just so annoying. I just feel like I am just paying out loads of money at the minute on cars and yeah, everything else. But anyway, so he was supposed to be coming today, which was great because we've been like 10 days now without hot water or heating. And he messaged yesterday to say that he's been near somebody that's got coronavirus, and so he has to isolate, so he can't come. So we're still without hot water and heating for a few more days until he's done a test, and hopefully it will be negative and then he can come and fix it, which is just so frustrating. Fortunately, we have been able to get showers because my dad, I think I mentioned previously, he's moved and gone into sheltered housing, but his house is empty at the minute. He's going to be renting it out, but it's currently empty. And the heating and everything is still on in that house, so we've been going around there for showers, which is great because it is only a mile up the road. It's a little inconvenient, obviously, just not being able to just go upstairs and jump in the shower, but it's better than nothing, isn't it? It's better than using boiling pans of hot water so that you can try and get washed. But anyway, so that's been another issue this last couple of weeks, but hopefully that will get sorted soon. Right, so I've got all the carry trousers cut out now. The only other thing I need, I think, is some wide elastic, which I do have when I can find it. Yes, this width elastic, which is great actually. So right, let's get these sewn up and hopefully finished.
We got everything we need right here, wine and burning chemistry, you and me alone, you and me alone. Me. me. Dancing in the colors, lightning. Blowing up a thunder, wash it over me, yeah. We got everything we need right.
I love sewer rip patterns, but these instructions are fine. It's just the pictures are awful. If I just go back to the beginning and I'll show you what I mean. You know, look at the fabric that they've chosen. How difficult is it to see what they're asking you to do when the fabric is this busy? You know, photos are great, but when they're going to use, you know, pictures of fabric that is busy like that, you can't see what you're doing. Anyway, I just wanted to show you one tip that they have shown you, which is really good. You know how when you make waistbands that are elastic, or anything, any sort of casing that you have to put elastic in, and when you sew over the seam allowances at the side seams, or in this case the front of the waistband seam, you end up with, when you're trying to feed the elastic through, I don't know about you, but it always gets stuck underneath, and you have to really wiggle and manipulate the fabric to get the elastic to go through the channel. Well, one of the tips that they tell you in this is to not stitch over the seam allowance. So you stitch up to the seam allowance, tie off, and then flip the seam allowance over, and then carry on stitching, so that the seam allowance remains loose inside, in this case the waistband, but obviously in the casing if you're doing a casing. And that means then that no matter which way you feed your elastic from, it's going to go through and not get stuck behind it, which is just ingenious.
Right, trousers are done. It is about 1 o'clock Saturday afternoon and I've got the carry trousers finished, so let me put you down and I'll show you what they look like. Right then, so yeah, they have this flat front here, which is great, and then obviously it's elasticated around the rest. The only thing I'm not, I mean, I don't know if they go with this jumper, but I really like them. I do really like them. These pockets are huge, that's the only thing. And the only thing I'm not sure about is the fact that they do sort of stick out a bit because they're so big. They have all been understitched totally. But yeah, I mean, I'm not sure if, well, actually I think they do go with this jumper, to be honest. But yeah, I really like them. This is a tensile twill that I think I originally got from Rainbow Fabrics in Kilburn, and I know they're quite plain, but I wanted something that I could wear casually, a bit like this, but also for work, for going to the surgery as well when I do my locum shifts. And I think, you know, with a nice blouse, they'll be okay for that, because we don't have to get dressed up. I'm glad I went with this size. I did a size 12 waist, but the waist is a bit big. I don't know if you can see that. And I mean, I think the finished measurements on the size 12 waist is a 30 inch. Now, my waist is a bit smaller. Mine's about 28 and a half now. So I've got a fair bit of looseness around there, but if I'd have gone down a size, I don't think I'd have got these over my hips. That's the only thing. Yeah, I mean, when these are pulled straight, they've got these sort of they've got these little pleats at the front. I don't know if you can see that as well. When they're sort of straight, then those pockets do sit a bit flatter, but yeah, I'm not sure about the pockets. That's the only thing, but maybe with a good a press and a wash, they'll be okay. I don't want them to make me look bigger, that's the thing. This tensile twill has no stretch in it whatsoever, so you know, I needed to make sure that I didn't go down too small a size, but I like them. I like them. I think they're going to be great. They are sort of, I don't know if you can see, ankle length or just below ankle length. They come to sort of the top of my foot. I'm covered in black threads at the minute, but yeah, I do like them. I think they're really nice. So right, God, my hair is a mess today. Right, I am going to. Martin's just at the door. I've locked him out. I haven't really. He's been to get a drill because he's going to put the mirror up, aren't you?
Yes, dear.
You're going to put the mirror up?
Yes, dear.
Yes, yes.
I do as I'm told.
What do you think to my trousers?
Very
nice.
Them? I think the black cotton threads on your jumper really finish it off.
They look great, don't they? So, so he's going to put my mirror up and then we just need to nip out. There's a few bits of shopping that we need to get. And then I'm going to make a start on make number two.
Is up. And looks fabulous. Yeah, really pleased with it. I think it really finishes off the room really nicely. Yes, do you think?
Yeah.
Right, so trousers are done. We're back from shopping and I am now going to get on with cutting out the heather dress. So we'll see how far we get with that today. Right, you're really not going to see this very well because the light is rapidly fading and I've had to put the ceiling light on. That's the word, that's what I meant. But the heather dress is almost finished. I just have to hem the sleeves and hem the skirt portion as well. I don't know if you can just see that. I've got bare legs at the minute and just socks on, which obviously I would not wear this with socks, I would wear it with tights. I actually cut out the full length sleeves and I quite like it full length, to be honest. I was originally going to do just the elbow length, but I think the full length sleeves look quite nice. So I'm a little bit annoyed with the neckband because it is just gaping a little bit, but I think I can get away with it. I did stretch it as much as I could actually to get it to fit. It's got the pockets in here, you really can't see this, but hopefully I'll be able to take some better pictures in normal daylight. But it's got the curved pockets just here. I have lengthened this, I haven't lengthened the sleeves actually, I've just cut these out as they were, and once they're hemmed they'll probably be about bracelet length, I would think. But I'm really liking it, I think it's really nice. So I'm hoping now I've lost some weight that this sort of silhouette suits me a little bit better than it did. It's really warm actually, this fabric is so warm. I think with tights it's gonna look really nice for winter. So all in all, a productive day. I've managed to get my carry trousers and obviously the heather dress done, and I think I'm gonna give it a rest now for the rest of today and just chill out. It's really foggy outside. I don't know if you can see just over my shoulder, the fog has not lifted all day here, but it's sort of just started lifting a little bit about 3/4 of an hour ago, and then it's got really thick again, so it's really coming in. But yeah, I really love this dress, it's lovely. So this is the size 10 that I made. As I say, I haven't done this dress for about 3 years now, and I'd cut out the size 10, so I just went with it and hoped for the best, and it fits fine. It's bodycon style anyway. This fabric is bodycon style, but I think it looks okay. And I think, as I say, with tights and boots, there you go, you can see my knees now, tights and boots, it's gonna look really good. So I still have the new look dress to trace out, and also the avid seamstress day dress, I've got that to trace out too. I might have a go at one of those later on, but I'm starving. I've hardly had anything to eat all day, so I'm really hungry. I think I'm going to get this hemmed tomorrow, because the problem with obviously artificial light and dark fabrics, it's really hard to see. So, and the light's not brilliant in my sewing room, so I think I'm going to leave it well tomorrow and get this hemmed tomorrow. Good morning and happy Sunday. So today I have been up early and I've been for an 8 mile run, which hence why my hair is still wet. Following that, being through to my dad's old house to have a shower, because obviously we still don't have any hot water. So I've just got my hoodie on and my Hudson's that I made earlier in the year while I sort of get, I don't know, yeah, because it's one of those days where I'm just going to be chilling at home, I think. So Martin has just nipped back to the supermarket because I don't know if you can just see on the breakfast bar there, that's Nigella Lawson's Christmas book, and we're going to make our Christmas cakes. So, well, what we're going to do is obviously soak the fruit overnight and probably make them tomorrow because we're off tomorrow. So he's just gone to get all the ingredients that we need for that. And I am in the middle of tracing out the N6594, I think it is, which I think I showed you yesterday. So I've just traced out all the bodice pieces, and it's one of those multi-size patterns which I'm a bit unsure what size to make because I've measured myself and I'm hitting in between the 12 and a 14. With respect to, I mean, this is quite a fitted bodice, and I think the 12 will be very fitted, but the 14 there'll be too much ease. So the problem is the sizes of the bodice pieces aren't nested on the pattern, they're sort of individual. So I think what I'm going to do is cut out the size 12 and do a smaller seam allowance, and hope that works. So we'll see how we get on with that. But I've traced off all the bodice pieces anyway, and the skirt pieces, I'm going to be a bit of a, I'm going to be a bit of a rebel, and I am just going to cut those out because I will never alter size with the skirt pieces. I'm just going to cut out the 12 waist and grade out to the 14 to give me plenty of ease over the hips, and I think that will be fine. So I'm going to get on with that, and then hopefully we can get the fabric cut out and get on with it.
What you do?
Cut out. This is the bodice pieces here, and the skirt pieces are there. Fortunately, I did manage to get everything out of it, but I think the skirt is probably just going to be a little bit shorter than I would probably really like, but I think it'll be fine with tights. These three pieces need interfacing, so I've just grabbed my interfacing from upstairs, and I'm going to do that now, and then we can get sewing.
Right, I'm sewing. I'm just working on the bodice at the minute, and this is actually quite tough, I'll be honest. There's lots of pieces to it, which is fine. Lots of gathering, which is fine. The collar was a little bit of a challenge. And this viscose is lovely, but it's, you know, viscose, and viscose is flimsy. And it's not very robust, is it? That's the problem. And the issue I've had is attaching the collar at the front and the facing, because you do it all in one, and I've got a little bit of a pull. I'm really annoyed about it because it's right at the centre, but you can see it. However, I'm sort of thinking that with the fabric being quite busy, that it's not going to make too much of an issue. So we'll see how it goes. I've shown Martin and he can't see it. He can't see the pole, but I can see it and you'll see it. It's really annoying because, as I say, I had to unpick it, and the problem is unpicking viscose, you know, it's easy to pull the fabric, isn't it? But never mind, things don't, you know, it's the end of the world, is it? I don't know if you're wobbling because I've got you stood on top of my sewing machine at the minute. It's about, actually, I don't know what time it is. 2:15. Can't get my son out of his bed today. He's still in bed. He is awake, but he won't get out of bed. 17-year-old, say. So I'm just attaching the midriff section now and the midriff facing. And then I will show you so you can have a look at this pull. So this is the bodice so far. Hang on, let me just hold it up under the arms. The side seams aren't finished yet, and it's got this gorgeous little collar. I've got the midriff bit on now. Hopefully you can just see that lovely gathering there. And yeah, the pull is right at the centre. You can just see it there. I think, you know, from far away you can't see it, can you? So I think it'll be okay. But yeah, just getting this collar in and the facing underneath was quite quite a challenge. But yeah, it's more or less done. I think I've just got the sleeves to attach. All right, hang on. Next we are press midriff and midriff facing down, base draw edges together. So yeah, inside, if I just turn it inside out, I'll show you it inside out. We've got the midriff facing, which is there. So I need to go and press this now and then just baste the bottom of that midriff section together so it's all nicely encased inside. So it will be something like that on the inside and that on the outside. I'm holding it upside down, obviously. Now, I've stitched the shoulder seams on my overlocker, and I do like, on viscose, I do like to do French seams. However, this, I think I mentioned earlier, didn't I, that I have cut out a size 12 and I'm going to use narrower seams. A narrower seam allowance. So I was sort of thinking that actually I don't want to be French seaming this because I'm not going to have enough of a seam allowance to do that. So I mean, maybe if I'd have cut out the 14, but the 14 I know would have been too big around my shoulders, definitely. So anyway, we'll just see how it goes. At the end of the day, if it doesn't fit, it doesn't fit. So right, I've pinned that together. I'm just going to baste that, and then I think at that point we're ready to put the sleeves in. Oh no, sew up the side seams. There we go. Sew up the side seams, and then put the sleeves in, and then we'll be onto the skirt. There's no fastenings in this dress, actually. I wasn't sure if it would have a zip in, but it doesn't. It's literally pull on over your head. Right, so that's that bit done. So I've got the midriff front and facing stitched now, and I'm going to do the side seams. But I'm going to stitch the side seams at 3/8 of an inch because that'll give me another 1/2 inch, which I think I'm going to need to get to just, you know, around my bust, really. So we'll get on with that, and we'll get the sleeves in and see what the bodice looks like. Right,
Right, bodice is done. It does have a zip in. Silly me, of course it has a zip in. I did wonder how I was going to get this on. I've got the sleeves in. It's a side zip, which is a bit annoying because I'm not keen on side zips, but never mind. I've got the, it's got the lovely little gathers just at the top there. It doesn't have a yoke actually. The shoulder seam from the back bodice piece comes over the front. I really like this collar. I'm just a bit annoyed about that little bit of a pull there, but never mind. Like how the gathers over the midriff, and that's the back. The collar is sitting nice. So I'm onto the skirt now. Fortunately, I think the skirt will be fairly straightforward because it literally is just sewing them all together. Sewing all the pieces together. So I'm really loving this fabric though. It's just really pretty, so I think it's great for this time of year. So I haven't hemmed the sleeves yet, but I will do that at the end when I hem the actual dress, and let's just fingers crossed hope it fits. Right, so I've got the skirt on, but it's not right. It's looking lovely. When I come from a distance here, it looks really great, but the front skirt pattern piece is pleated, and this pleat is not in the right place because the center line of the front is there clearly, and you've got a seam from the side panel piece here, and then the other seam is here. Everything matches up at the side, but this has a big pleat in it, and clearly I've got that in the wrong place, so I am going to have to unpick that, which is fine because I've not overlocked it or finished the seam in there at all, so that's okay. But I've had enough today. I think it's one of those moments when I need to step away from this now, so I'm gonna step away from the sewing machine and go just have a little bit of time relaxing, I think, and probably tackle that tomorrow, get that front piece off and undo the pleat and move it to the right part. It's another foggy morning. Good morning and happy Monday. So today is day three of my long weekend off work. Back at work tomorrow, boo. I'm going for a run with Judy later this afternoon, but before that I need to do some more work on that dress from yesterday. Martin is downstairs just preparing the Christmas cakes, and they're going to go in the oven today, which is amazing, so the house is going to smell divine. And I need to unpick the pleat on that skirt at the front of the dress from yesterday, because I've clearly got that pleat in totally the wrong place, which is just bizarre. But anyway, that serves me right for not reading the instructions very well, doesn't it? So I'm going to have a go at that and try and get that sorted, and then hopefully get that dress finished. Not sure if I'm going to get the opportunity to start the day dress, because that was my fourth planned make for this weekend, but I'm not sure I'm going to get the opportunity to do that because I need to get this dress finished. And I've still got the sleeves and the bottom hem to do on the heather dress as well that I made on Saturday. That's not finished yet either, so I'm going to try and get those finishing off bits done first before I make a start on the day dress. Right, so Martin's baking Christmas cake. How are you doing?
My butter's maybe a bit harder than it should have been to start with, but I will prevail.
Prevail?
Prevail. I will overcome. It will still be my usual awesome Christmas cake.
It's going to be gorgeous. So he's got the tin lined.
Are we behold my chopped nuts, pecans and walnuts. Lovely. And behold my fruit.
Oh, it smells divine. It really does. Yes.
And my ingredients.
So how many cakes are you making? We're doing three, aren't we?
Yes, I am doing three.
We're doing three because we're having
No. Can we rephrase that? I'm doing three.
You. Me. Okay. Martin's doing three cakes. One for us. One, us. One for Bronte and one for my dad. So, so busy day while I sew.
Yes. The day off work making Christmas cakes. There's nothing better.
And it's done. I've just tied my hair up so that you can hopefully see the lovely detail around the collar. So I'm just going to take you into my bedroom and then show you the finished dress. So here we are. I love this dress. I think it's so feminine. Martin loves it. I've got a little bit of looseness around here. I think, to be perfectly honest, I could have probably just done the straight size 12 and just graded out across the 14 for the hips, which I still need. But yeah, I absolutely love it. It's beautiful. It's really beautiful. It's more or less finished. I've just got to hem it because I don't know if you can sort of see the length there. I'm just going to leave it to, you know, to just drop, because this skirt is in 1, 2, 3, 4 panels, and yeah, I think the hem might drop a little bit, so I'm going to leave it on my mannequin for a couple of days and then probably hem it later on in the week. But otherwise it's finished. I have the invisible zip is in the side here, and actually I quite like it. I think I could have probably, I mean, I did cut the size 12 bodice, and I probably, I think I did the side seams just at 3/8 of an inch rather than a full 5/8 of an inch. And to be honest, I could have just done the full 5/8 of an inch. I think a straight size 12 bodice will fit me. I lengthened the upper bodice part above the midriff section by an inch, and that's worked really well because I've got a underwire bra on at the minute, and the underwire is literally just sitting there just above the midriff portion, so that's worked really well for me. I cut the size 14 sleeves because I weren't sure whether the 12s would maybe just be a little bit too tight, and I'm glad that I did that because the 14 fits me really, really well. It's got darts in the back bodice and the skirt. I really like the skirt. Now the pleat detail is here, so there is like a pleated portion, you can't really see it, but there's like a pleated portion here that runs down into a pleat at the front of the skirt. And to be perfectly honest, I don't think it's necessary. And I think what you do is you cut the back panel on the fold and the front mid panel of the skirt is cut as one piece, and then the right front panel is one piece, and then the left front panel is one piece. I think when I make this again, because I am going to make this again because I really like this dress and I like how it looks on me, I think I am just going to mirror image or just cut two of the right front panel pieces and just omit this bit with the pleat, because I don't think it serves any purpose whatsoever, to be honest. And I think I would prefer it without that pleat in the front. But no, I really like it. I love this fabric. It's quite lightweight, so, but you know, I mean, the colours are really nice for this time of year, but I think that I probably could do with wearing a vest or something underneath it, as well as my tights for winter. I think I'll probably just need that bit extra, but obviously I can get a cardigan over the top of this as well. I'm going to put you down on the window ledge and then I'll stand back so you can have a little bit of a better look at it. There we go. So hopefully you can see that a little bit better now, and the length is just sort of, once it's hemmed, it'll be perfect length for me, just below my knees. But I really like it. I think it's really lovely. I'll just turn around so you can see. Yeah, so it's really pretty. It's really, it's got a really 19 sort of 40s vibe to it, I think. But yeah, I think, as I say, I think I could just, you know, there is still a fair bit of ease in the top, so I could probably easily just do a full 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, I think. And yeah, it's lovely. I really, really like it. Right, so I'm going to put this on the mannequin and get changed, and I think I'll just take my hair back out again out of that clip, and I think I am now going to trace off the day dress and hopefully get started on that. So I didn't expect redoing the pleat on this to be as easy as it was. I thought it would probably take me a bit more time, but it was straightforward. But definitely when I make this again, I am gonna just omit that pattern piece altogether and just double up on the right front pattern piece, because I think that will just give me, yeah, it'll give me less of a headache with that pleat. And also I just don't think it needs it, to be honest. So right, let me get changed and we'll move on to make number 4. First cake is done. Doesn't that look gorgeous? I wish you could smell this, because it smells incredible. Martin's just nipped to the shop to get some foil. I am just making some lunch, and cake number 2 has just gone in the oven. So I'm having poached eggs on toast for lunch, and I have got the day dress
all cut out. So while that is, while the water's heating up to make my poached eggs, I am just going to get darts pinned on the day dress bodice. And hopefully I can get that sewn up this afternoon.
Right, I've got you balanced on top of my sewing machine again. So I'm on with the bodice and I am French seaming this one because there is a fair bit of ease in the this dress. As far as I can see, I aren't actually following the instructions, I'm just doing it my own way. I've done enough of darted bodices now to know how they go together. So so I'm just stitching it myself. So I've done the darts. I have attached the shoulder seams with French seams. I have attached the neck facing and I'm now just doing the side seams. I've done the first part of the French seam and I'm just doing the second part now. And then I am going to just hand tack the, well, actually, I'm going to finish off the facing on my overlocker and then I am going to hand tack facing to the shoulder seams of the bodice. Sorry if you're wobbling a little bit there. That's one side. And then it's just going to be a case of attaching the sleeves. You are wobbling a bit, aren't you? And then getting the skirt on. I'm just, while I'm doing this actually, I'm just watching Lisa Comfort's sew along. She's got a live sew along. I think they're sewing the Thea dress today. So the bodice looks, obviously it's not got the sleeves in yet, but it looks something like that so far, which is quite nice. I love the neckline. It's finished off really nice actually. It's quite neat. I've understitched it, as you can probably see. A bit worried that I don't have a suitable zip for this dress because I was rooting around for a zip for that dress this morning. That one there. The only green zips that I could see in my bag of zips were light green, which is no good really for this. So and I don't think I've got any black ones either, not invisible ones. So we'll see how we get on. Right, let's crack on. Right, I am up to sewing the hem on the dress and I have had a couple of major issues with this dress. Mainly that I have French seamed it all. You wouldn't think it, for this is just the overlocked back seam where the zip is. But honestly, I have French seamed at all. There you go. Look, you can see a French seam there. And when I French seamed the waistband as well, and I did add a good inch onto the upper bodice. But what I stupidly did when I was trimming down the French seam of the waistline is I cut through my bodice. So it's meant that I've had to run a new waistband seam a good inch higher than, so the inch that I included, the inch that I lengthened my bodice by, I've now lost, which is fine. It still fits. It's a little bit loose and obviously it's hitting just above my waist, but it still looks okay. I've tried it on. So I'm just going to do a blind hem on my bottom hem because I just love blind hems. I just think they finish off these kind of dresses really nicely than just a stitched hem, and I really can't be bothered hand hemming it. So I have done a blind hem tutorial before. It's on my channel somewhere. If I can find it, I will link to it down below. But essentially all you need to do is press up your hem like I've done here, and then this is looking at it obviously from the inside, and then you just fold it back on itself so that the actual hem bit is peeking out, because you're going to be running your stitches along the actual hem, not the garment, if that makes sense. And just a little stitch is going to come in and get the garment. So all I do is fold up your hem, press up your hem like that, and then fold it back on itself. And you don't need to do it by a lot, just
I don't know what that is, probably a centimetre or so, would you say? Something like that. So I'm just going to pin this all the way around. It's only mid-afternoon, but the light is really poor, actually. It came out really nice and sunny over lunchtime, and me and Martin went out for a little walk, and then it's come really dark again. So, and we've had 3 days of fog, I think I mentioned that this morning, and it finally cleared today at lunchtime, and then it's become foggy, getting foggy again. So I do like the fog, though. I like running in the fog because it's really eerie and atmospheric. Right, so that's now all pinned. Hopefully you can just see that there. Now, the blind hem stitch is, I will show you, it's this one here. So it looks a bit like that. So we're going to use the straight stitches that go along the actual hem, and then you'll get, every so often you'll get like a zigzag stitch that just catches the main fabric of the dress, which gives you that invisible stitch. Now you have to play about with your settings a little bit for your machine to get this right, and dependent on the width of the hem that you've pulled up. But I just use my clear view foot. I don't. As long as you've got enough room for your needle to move across, you don't need a special foot for this either. So I'm just going to narrow the zigzag slightly. And I'll just narrow it just a bit more. And then off we go. Try as much as possible to get the little gap in the center of the clear view foot along the folded part of the fabric. So you should end up with something that looks like that. I don't know if you can see that. Something that looks like that. So it's fairly, you can just see the little stitches every so often, but once that's pressed, you won't see it at all. Right, the dress is done. So I'm gonna put you down and show you how it looks. Okay, so this is the Avid Seamstress Day Dress, and I love this fabric. It's absolutely beautiful. This is a double gauze with embroidered gold spots on, and it's in a gorgeous emerald green, and I think I got this last year or the year before. I can't remember where I got it from now, but it's definitely, I think it's Atelier Brunette. I actually really like this dress. I did alter the pattern slightly. I made a size 3, and it's got darts, waist darts, bust darts here, which I lowered by half an inch, and I lowered the top of the waist darts by half an inch as well. I did lengthen the bodice, because if you can see where my hands are now is where my waist is, and obviously the waistline of this is a lot higher. Now, I did lengthen the bodice by an inch, but I had a major catastrophe when I was French seaming the waistband, and I ended up cutting into the bodice front, so I've had to raise it above where I'd cut into it, which means that that inch that I had added in, I've lost totally. But you know, at the end of the day, I've managed to save the dress. So it's quite loose fitting, which is fine, because this is, you know, unlike the other one that I made yesterday and finished this morning, I wanted this to be much more of a casual dress I can wear with a nice chunky cardigan and wear with my boots. I've got it on with my tights, and it does come to just above my knee. I did add on a good inch and a half to the bottom of the dress as well. This dress does have inseam pockets, but I decided to omit them just because I felt that, you know, it was just going to add width to my hips.
And I'm quite glad I did that. I don't always use pockets in dresses anyway, so it's not, you know, it's not a big deal for me. It's got a zip at the back and back waist starts as well, just there. Invisible zip in the back. I did have a green one. I managed to find a green one, but it's not the right green, but I'm hoping that it's not too obvious. And yeah, most of it is French seamed apart from the back seam with the zip in, and it's lovely. It's really, really nice. I'm really glad that I finally got this fabric made up. Definitely will make this dress again. The other thing that I did, the skirt pieces, you've got a front skirt piece which it says cut one out of, but I just folded it in half and did it that way and cut it on the fold, and then two back skirt pieces, and they're essentially a rectangle, and then it's gathered in. Now you'll probably notice there's not a lot of gathers in mine, and that's deliberate, because what I did was I cut the size 3, but then I tapered towards the top, right down to the smallest size, and then an extra half inch on either side, so that it just removed a lot of the gathering. I don't always think that that's totally flattering, especially at my age. But anyway, I really love it. Really, really happy with it. I think I'll get a lot of wear out of this, and it's great for showing off a nice print, I guess, because, you know, this fabric is lovely, and I think it's a nice style for this kind of fabric. So, total win. Pretty amazed that I've actually got as much as I'd planned to get done this weekend. I've got two dresses done, apart from obviously one needs hemming still. No, actually two needs hemming. And I've got three dresses and a pair of trousers made. So all in all, it's been a really good 3 days off work. Back to work tomorrow though. Martin is just making slow gin now, which is using the slows that we got in my last vlog. We've not got around to doing that yet, so we're just doing that now and hoping that it'll be ready for Christmas, because usually it needs a good 3 months, but we'll see. But yeah, I think I'm gonna love you and leave you here for my vlog this week. I hope you've enjoyed seeing everything that I've been getting up to, and enjoy me getting all these makes done. I didn't get my September and October makes vlog filmed over the weekend. I was planning to, and I just didn't get a chance to do it. So I think I am going to get that done this weekend, and hopefully that will be up next week for you. So take care of yourselves, and I will see you really soon. Bye.